So today's a pretty exciting day. Coming up that drive in about 30 minutes or so is our new sawmill. So we got lots of piles of lumber around from clearing the garden and around the house to start sawmilling. We need to cut wood for the shelters over the sawmill, shelters over the new cut lumber. Front deck porch needs new lumber, and we're gonna finish the basement and put two new rooms and a bathroom down there. So pretty exciting. Gotta get the sawmill, put it together, put the trailer together, put the sawmill on the trailer, clear the sawmill area, which we started last week, and then go over there and start milling. I've never done this before. It'll be fun, interesting time to learn how to do it. I know those boards are gonna be heavy, 16 foot long logs, some of them 30 inches in diameter. I will cut 12 inch wide, inch and a half boards. They're gonna be heavy, gonna need help.
Dad, what you working on?
You know, when I was a kid, we used to get these kits and put them together. That was so much fun, nuts and bolts and stuff. That's what this is, a big tinker toy project.
This is a Lego set.
This is a Lego set. This
Holy cow, look at all of these. Look at all of this.
This is just the trailer.
Hi, Mom.
This is the trailer. That's the sawmill, so gotta put the trailer together first. And then build the sawmill on the trailer.
Wow. Where's the instruction pamphlet for it?
Right there. It's a book. No pamphlet, it's a book.
You know what I mean. Oh my. Holy cow. Yeah. Little light. Oh wait, that's for the... Oh. Oh wow. Oh man. This is going to be a project.
Yes, it is. But this stuff is fun. I like doing this stuff. Started. It's going to be a 16 foot trailer. There's the other two pieces down there. They go on either end. And then this is all the sawmill pieces over there and sawmill over there. So we build the trailer and then we build the sawmill on top of the trailer. So day two, let's see how far we can get. String level, string running along the frame going that way. It's level now this way. We had a big drop off this way. So it's level that way. I think it's pretty much level now. That's the full size of the trailer. Actually, this isn't the trailer. This is just the stand. For the sawmill, it goes on the trailer. This bolts on the trailer. We haven't even started the trailer yet. So this is taking about an hour this morning just to get the two ends on and get it level, but I think we're ready to keep going. Well, geez, now it's afternoon after lunch. A lot of bolts, a lot of tightening, a lot of reading instructions, getting them wrong. So we've got everything on for the platform now. So now we're going to start installing the jacks next. Yep. We're on page 29 of 68. A lot of pages to go. Jacks, cross beams. Keep at it. All right, well, it's like 3 o'clock, I think, second day. And it's time for the wiring harness for the trailer. Hadn't started on the sawmill yet. Tires, the fenders, the jacks, all the brackets are on, the tongue is on, everything's bolted down. So put the lights on, and then I think we're getting close with the trailer. We start on the sawmill. So I don't think I'll get done today, but we'll keep working at it and see. It's a lot of work to put a trailer together. Can't wait to start on the sawmill. What do you think, Mo? Plus, I have to throw stuff for Mo all the time. Well, it's morning on the third day, and we got it all together. So the head is all put together, just got to tighten all the bolts once we set it on. Now we're going to pick it up with the skid loader and set it on there and let it settle down, let the dog settle down, and we'll be good to go. Then all we got to do is level the ground to install it. Easy. Well, we're all together. Saw heads on it, doing some last minute adjustment. Put the last few things on it. Now we're on page 63 of 112. Grease. Engine oil.
So we took dirt from there, we took dirt from there, and I plan on stacking logs there and over there, and we smoothed out the road and we made a platform. So sawmill is all set up, leveled, ready to start cutting. I had to bring it in with the truck and then move it in there by hand. It wasn't impossible, but it was heavy. So exciting part's coming. Saw the first log. That's my very first board cut from the sawmill. So there's the board I cut. I didn't have it square because the blade wasn't square, so I had to redo it. But I'm gonna cut 24 inches off of this. I'm gonna make a platform right there to put the logs on. And yep. And then I'm gonna start working on the posts for the shelter over the sawmill itself. But I gotta get this off of here and I can't carry it, it's too big. So, cool. Day two. Starting to learn how to use it. Starting to figure out the right cuts and the right measurements. That's called the log bunk that's built. Hopefully that's gonna stand. I'm about to put some logs on it. Those 4x4s are removable and so I can get around and then I can just put the 4x when I'm ready to roll the log on. So hopefully that'll hold 4 or 5 logs. So I'm gonna take the excavator right now, take some of those logs, put them over here. One of them is gonna be that 24 foot log because that'll be the cross members for the shelter, which is next for the saw.
First log on the bunk.
We need one by material. We got a 16 inch log. So, kind of gnarly though, isn't it?
I think it's rad.
It's rad. So, we take these, my little handy dandy log bunks, rollers, put them on. You think it'd be a good idea to roll the log and stand right here?
You could do it once.
It would hurt. That log probably weighs a couple thousand pounds.
Sheesh! That's more than seven.
This is called a cant hook.
Okay.
Because when we get the log cut down into a square, it's called a cant. So.
Huh. The more you know.
Well, let's see. Can you and I roll this thing at all? Ready?
Yeah.
It's sappy.
Yeah, it is. That's why we're gloves.
All right, this one. Where do you keep the turpentine?
Turpentine comes from that sap.
I mean the pine sole.
I took it back. I didn't need it. Didn't work. Okay, let's see. We may just cut it right like that. Alright, it's gotta move over though.
Okay. How do we move it over?
Physical labor. This end's gotta go over.
Okay, so we need the cant hook for it?
No, you can't. The cant hook's for rolling. Here we either gotta, if we can't push it, we get a big log and try to force it over. But really, you just try to. Like that. There we go. That's all
needed.
Okay. All right. So we don't have anything square on it, so it doesn't really matter. We got to get something square. So we put these locks on it, so it doesn't go anywhere on us, but it's not going anywhere because it's so big. And then we just start cutting. So we raise the saw head up. So this is a band saw. That's the band right there. And raise it up like that. Then we're gonna start a motor. We'll have to yell. So up here, same kind of thing. We got a choke, gas is on, but we got electric start.
About it. over. Easy enough. And we'll lock it on the back side. Yep. So you push the bottom in like this, have it open. Push the bottom in as much as you can.
Three quarters.
Thank you.